Jong.
The silhouettes in the dark stand still in worship to the calm flowing waters that bless this glorious city. With the power of cleansing souls and the mark of being India's purest river, the Narmada lends life to the ancient city of Maheshwar. This temple town finds its mention in the epics of Mahabharata and Ramayana and is still an important religious destination. An important city at the dawn of Indian civilization, Maheshwar reached its cultural zenith under Devi Ahilyabai Holkar. As she announced Maheshwar capital of her state, Devi Ahilyabai commissioned the construction of numerous temples, ghats and other structures. During this period, she also invited weavers from other princely states to settle in Maheshwar. The weavers were asked to replicate the intricate designs of the fort on fabric, and in doing so, she gave origin to the unique and widely celebrated Maheshwari Sari.
Maheshwar is known for its gold border, its checks, and very, very fine texture and its beauty.
It had a very unique border, which, if you see the old records, is inspired from the fort, the architecture that you see around yourself. And the sensitivity of the border comes from the flowing river that you see here. So the borders, each border has a name. You have a border with the name Narmada, and it carries the same fluidity as the river.
The names were so exquisite, like Bulbuli Chashm, you know, black and white, Anar Kadana, which was the combination of pink, white and red, then Abrava was flowing water, turquoise blue, dark blue, and a touch of white.
The elaborate process of weaving starts with the designing of the sari, which is inspired largely by the designs engraved on the walls of the fort. Cotton and silk threads both require dyeing before they can be used on the loom. This process starts with dipping them in a solution of Turkish oil and bleaching powder. The threads are then dipped in a solution of the dye and warm water a number of times until the desired color is achieved. Finally, the threads are washed and hung to dry. After dyeing, the yarn is normally received by the weaver in the form of bundles. The threads then need to be detangled and stretched in order to make them tighter and suitable for the warp and the weft. A charkha is used to convert the bundles into small rolls called bobbins. As the silk fiber used is very delicate, a warp machine is used for warping or preparing the tana. The warp roll is then placed at the extreme end of the loom and the weaving begins. Here the weaver engages in three different actions simultaneously. The right hand operates the string that provides motion to the shuttle carrying the bobbin weft across the threads of the warp. The left hand provides an up and down motion to the wooden frame of the loom that falls on the threads of the warp and the weft to guide them to their respective places in the cloth. Both legs move in rhythmic synchronization, providing the motion to the ruche, which helps the threads of the warp and the weft to interlock. The motion of the loom provides movement to the overhead punch card mechanism called dobby, which helps in weaving the border of the sari. There are up to 4,000 strings in a single warp, which makes the process of weaving time-consuming and complex. Maheshwari has always excited textile lovers and held a special place in the hearts of even the most discerning customers. However, the decades of the 50s and 60s saw a sharp decline in the demand for the fabric, owing to changing aesthetics and demographics.
You know, markets change, tastes change. So you have to be one step ahead.
These changes are obviously inevitable because the lifestyle is changing. The aesthetic sensibility is also changing, and also the structuring of the garment, given the global environment and the homogenization is also changing.
Today, the modernization has brought a difference in these textiles. Today we not only try and do the traditional saris, but we're also changing according to the times.
With their innovative schemes and new policies, the state government partnered with designers, developers and organizations to re-establish the market for Maheshwari.
I did work with Madhya Pradesh government, and it was one of the best. They did one of the finest program for handicrafts development.
शासन के तरफ से ये हुआ कि उसको लूम, राम मटेरियल ये सब उपलब्ध कराया गया. लूम तो 100% अनुदान पे भी और 50% पे भी, दोनों अलग अलग मद में दिया गया. और राम मटेरियल के लिए यार्न बैंक खोल दिया गवर्नमेंट ने, तो यार्न उसको ही मिलने लग गया. और मध्य प्रदेश हस्तशिल्प विकास निगम का ऑफिस है जो मृग नैनी का, वो भी बुनकर से माल खरीदते, पहले कम खरीदते थे, अब बहुत अधिक मात्रा में खरीदते हैं.
हमको जो पहले ट्रेनिंग दी गई है उसके अंदर हमको गवर्नमेंट से लूम मिले हुए हैं. लूम मिलने के बाद में कुछ सहायता अनुदान द्वारा मिली गई है और कुछ हमें मार्केटिंग के लिए बाहर जाने के लिए देते हैं.
One such organization that has made a monumental difference to the weavers and their craft is the Reva Society. Started by the Holkar family in 1979, this society has helped the weavers adapt and change to newer markets while also providing social upliftment.
When Reva came in, the Maheshwari has caught up and is doing extremely well.
Reva Society ne apne designer hon laaye aur unne jo product banaya usme kafi order milne laga, to bunkar ko isse kya hua ki ek to wages bahut zyada milne lag gaye. Pehle usko jo 50 rupaye milte the to usko seedhe 500 rupaye milne lag gaye, to uske halat mein ekdam sudhar aa gaya.
The president of the society is Shivaji Rao Holkar, and it was in 1978 when he was visiting Maheshwar again with his then wife Shalini Devi Holkar. There were certain weavers who approached them. As there was no royal patronage at that point, they asked them to help establish the weaving tradition again. And once they heard the stories of the weavers, they decided that I think it was time to re-establish the weaving heritage, what it was going on at the time of Ahilyabai Holkar.
Maheshwari over the years has reinvented itself according to the needs of the changing market and developed products that suit current sensibilities and market requirements. The government of Madhya Pradesh, its partners and Reva continue to support and further develop this inimitable textile. However, there is still a lot that can be achieved with further support and investment.
अब बुनकर को चाहिए कि उसका जो कच्चा माल मिल जाए, तो उसके लिए यार्न बैंक है. सिल्क यार्न बैंक नहीं है गवर्नमेंट की, सिल्क यार्न बैंक हो जाए और प्लस जो पक्का माल बना है वो टाइम से उसके खरीदी हो जाए.
Their skill level could be increased. Like just from weaving a neem resham, there could be more palla weavers. They could be taught to do more dentings or to experiment more with other yarns. So that exposure is very limited at present. Today, of course, the weavers can weave as many saris as they want. But where do they sell from? there are no retail or marketing opportunities for them. Retail is becoming a big challenge today. How to find the right people or the right place to sell from? So that is a big question in front of the whole of Maheshwar.
Marketing is a big thing, number one. Number two, distribution of their goods and a certain amount of design intervention. In addition, there is a need for good dyes houses, and it would be good if, you know, now the all the world over we become ecologically conscious, that it would be good if an attempt could be made to set up vegetable dye.
Both these places, Chanderi or Maheshwari, are literally sort of cultural biospheres, one of its kind, which need to be sort of conserved, you know, and seen as heritage places. You know, they may be, they have all the potential to be turned into museumized and tourism spaces where people can come, where people can add to their economy and add, you know, sort of greater thrust in terms of using a kind of a knowledge repository which is already there. The Madhya Pradesh government has been investing a lot in the weavers and the weaving technology. However, a lot remains to be done, since it is not really enough for their economic empowerment. And one of the main things which could really be done is to kind of identify, you know, not only identify, but to actually harness, you know, this knowledge repository, this knowledge know-how, which is rooted for generation and can be perpetuated further down the generations by making craft, design and art education a regular part of the schooling.
It's very important to teach the weavers and their children to carry this further and to have a sense of pride in what they are doing.
Today, this elegant fabric and its products have created a niche for themselves in the demanding global market. With the will to work hard and the flexibility to change with the times, Maheshwar looks to the future with anticipation and hopes to carry forward the magnificence of the heritage left behind by Devi Ahilyabai. Mm-hmm.